Hi guys, welcome back to another episode of Breakthrough UK with Urban Flash Season 2 in association with In The Streets, and I'm Dynamic, aka The Industry Stalker, and we've done a lot of stalking in all the episodes that we've done, but today, even though it's raining, we've managed to go out and find two amazing brothers, Ben AD and Young Ads. Now they're currently having their photo shoot done with Urban Flash, and I'm going to go and harass them and find out what they've been going on. Take care. Breakthrough UK. Who do you know to tell me if you're breakthrough?
A lot of people wanna make choices for me. Dead that. Yeah. I'm a young man now, respect that. I don't wanna talk, you can give me the cash and show young rat where all of the checks at. They wanna get revenge by talking like I'm a dead.
Showtime.
They wanna smile up in my face. My slimy never bagged in the hay.
So hi guys, lovely to have you with me.
You're right.
We're on a wall, so we're trying to do something different. I'm scared of heights, but these guys actually helped me get up onto the wall. So they're the money brothers. But seriously, what has been going on in the world of Ben AD and Young Ads?
The world of Ben AD and Young Ads, just music. Music. More music, innit?
Did you rehearse that?
No.
That was like ad-libs and more music. Okay, right, your names. I always ask everyone how they get their names, because, you know, some MCs are called MC Kill Your Mom, and you think, how did you get your name, you know? But how did you get your names? Are they your real names? How did you shorten them? Come on.
Yeah, my name's Benjamin, hence Benjamin. The AD, like, it stands for, everybody asks me about it, but, like, I kind of don't really want to, like, say, like, I want to do it on a track, so I want to address it at a later date. Like,
I whisper it in my ear and tell me.
I can tell you, but we can do that off camera, can
I? Oh, okay, so you're going to tell me off camera, that's good. Okay, so your name's a bit of a secret, and you are?
I'm just Young Ads, innit?
What's that, Young Advert?
No. Obviously, my name's Adam, shorted down to Ads, and, like, you see there's Young Jeezy and I'm young, innit, so I'm just Young Ads.
Yeah, like you're like what,
12? No.
I'm just joking. Now, how old are you, hon?
I'm 16 soon, still, next week.
So you're not even 16 yet? Oh, well done. So you know, like, a lot of these rappers, they call themselves young this and young that. What happens when you hit 30?
When I hit 30, I probably won't be making music when I hit 30.
Is this guy's ready for me? He's ready for me. Okay, now recently you guys have both been signed. Well done. Very proud of you. How did that come about?
Basically, there's no, like, if you want the long story, there's, like, basically what happened was we started banging out music, put a video together, Dope As It Gets. I knew it was going to go crazy. Adam didn't really think. He kind of played it down. I was like, no, this is going to go mad. These times, we didn't know, like, Grime Daily. We didn't know nobody like that. I hollered at Little D, asked him to get the video put on Grime Daily. Little D got it put on Grime Daily. Shouts to Little D. And, from there, it just went mad. Like, people were just going crazy. And then, who was it? Was it Pierre Ads? Pierre rang Ads and was like, oh, there's some guy that wants to holler at you, he's a manager. And Ads was like, oh, nah, but because we was already meeting different sets of people, yeah, different management, like, we were being courted by, yeah, we thought there were any guys. So the guy was like, no, this is N-Dubs' manager. So we was like, okay.
It was Richard, wasn't it? Because I spoke to Richard about you a lot before, yeah.
It was Rich Castillo, shout out to Rich. Yeah, and basically, you know what, initially he just hollered at Adam, so. Because we all had individual meetings and group meetings going on at the time. So we met him, went to a restaurant, like, started chopping it up. He was saying, yeah, he has a certain vision. Then Ads off his own back started showing him some of my music. And then he was like, nah, I want you two together. Like, and that's basically how it came together.
Who are you signed to?
Universal Records, and we are signed to the management company, which is 2-7, and that is
that's Richards.
Yeah.
You can die yourself, this ain't a game. No one in the scene can take my name, they can't spit, I'ma spit, they're all fake. I'm as real as it gets, I look for inspiration, but I can't find nobody yet. They don't realise young ads, and I'm as dope as it gets.
I'm as dope as it gets. If you wanna disagree, we can go for the test. If you really wanna do it, we can go and we can prove it.
Yo,
I'm moving the two steps, they just ain't gonna match in me.
And what's the deal with you and Chipmunk? Go on, did he give you a quick nudge, or I'll bring you in, love, you know, because Chipmunk was bringing you up. What happened with that?
Basically, we was in a meeting with Rich, me and Ben, and fucking Ben's phone just started going mad, innit? Like bare pins and that. At the time, my phone was fucked, innit? It wasn't working properly, yeah. So I couldn't get any reception, and then Ben's like, because obviously when you're in a meeting, you don't have your phone out, and Ben's like, oh no, rah, like some girl saying Chipmunk's talking about you on Twitter. Yeah. Obviously me, at first, I'm not gonna lie, I thought he was like maybe chatting shit about me or something, innit? Yeah. So I've gone, I've seen it now. And he's like, yeah, like young ads are gonna be the next big thing or whatever. So I was like, rah, like I was shocked in that. And then we went out. Well, he DM'd me his number, but I didn't ring him that night, innit? And then he rang my manager and he was like, I wanna take young ads out, like go out for a meal. He's showing me some of his second he's showing me some of Transition. Okay. And that tune with Chris Brown and all of that. So
basically Chipmunk just hollered at you, and yeah, he just really believes in you.
Yeah.
Okay, and have you kept in touch?
I was talking to him recently because he's been in and out of LA and that, but I'm still shouting out Chip, yeah, and Chip is my dog.
You better, innit? He brought you in, you better shout him out until you look really famous so you can forget. Nah, that was a joke.
I found a kid on YouTube who was like 14, his name was Young Ads. The words that was leaving his lips for his age was just, it was extraordinary.
Yeah.
It kind of reminded me of something that I had when I was a kid. I reached out, I found him, you know, met his manager, we went down for dinner, talked to him, just give that guidance that I wish someone gave me, man, you know.
Yeah.
So I'm about this.
Knocking out green in the crack field. Heard my bro was banging on his ring in Ashfield. Trying to get to the top, stuck in the block. My bro was writing me letters when he was stuck in block. I'm telling you this cause I was misguided. A hype kid excited by robberies and knifings. So many bad things I wanna take back. On the phone on my own to one of my Don Abs saying.
So guys, the legacy. Explain to me what the legacy is.
The legacy is basically, it's a team. And I know it sounds cliche, but it's more than a team. Like, we can have people around us, like close friends, that they don't even do music, and they can shout the legacy, and it's not a thing. But like, as artists, it's me, it's Young Ads, it's my boy C Major. He's our producer, like our main producer, like crazy. Louis Stark as well, which people should be hearing from really soon, and Swift. So that's like the team, but at the forefront right now it's me and Ads. So it's like an umbrella, like we all roll together day to day basis, and we're all around each other in and out of music. So it's like, you know, it's more than just a name.
And I guess even if two of you are shining, you are all kind of shining, yeah, in it, because it's a legacy.
It's the name.
It's a legacy.
The name's out there and everybody knows.
Yeah.
Then it's like, I don't know, everybody could be firing from all cylinders as individuals, because at the end of the day, we all make different music because we're different people.
And how old are you?
I turned 21 in February. Okay.
Now, where do you guys get your intelligence from? Because obviously there's a lot of people rapping right now, but when you guys do it, I noticed from a couple of the online viral videos that I was watching, yeah, that you guys were using, you know, like 13 letter words and that.
I don't know, like, I don't know, Grod, I suppose. Like, you know, we like our mum, she's a bright spark, but she, it's like as we grew up, like neither of us was really academic. Neither of us were academic in school. But I've always been good with English. I've always been like reading words and good with words and just writing. I like to write, and I like to, you know, I don't like to do the same thing that's always been done. It's just boring.
Bruv, this is my life and I don't do it for the fun of it. Yeah, I found an angle and my action was to run with it. Yeah, I'm trying to live a good life, aim to get the funding in. Yeah, my siblings spitting sickness and no one can trouble him. Just remember the surroundings have stained us. We're selfish young gunners, the environment has made us. I don't understand why they're denying me my fate when I'm in my own lane and I ain't taken from their plate. Look, let me be, let me breathe with my legacy.
And Ads, who's the hardest female MC in the UK?
In the UK? At the moment?
Yeah.
I don't know, you know, because like, you see Lioness? Like Lioness is like, she's been about from day in it. Like, she's one of the ones you don't even really need to mention, but from what I've seen, I don't know, because I like Miss Brat as well, but I like Nolé. I like Nolé.
We love Nolé.
Yeah.
Who's a fucking gangster? Zed, don't let me go on crud. I'll put these MCs right under the mud like spuds. I'll lay them out flat on the floor like rocks.
I think Leisha. Yeah, I think Leisha's big.
Okay, so we're going to say what we're saying. Nolé and Leisha right now, yeah? Yeah, as a top. But everyone else we still love.
Everyone else is good. Like they're doing the females proud.
They know how to act when I arrive. Give them an Oscar because they love me. I'm on my Justin Bieber. Got the ice on my wrist. Encrusted fever. He likes it fast and furious. I call him Vin Diesel. He likes to gas to all of us. I tell him.
And before I let you go back to your photo shoot, if there was an MC,
yeah,
that you could go like this and it'd go away forever, who would it be?
I don't know. It's kind of like, I don't hate no one, innit? Yeah. But I don't really like a lot. So it's like, no, realistically, because everyone's on this, like, life's hard, let's be depressed.
We've got the NHS here. It's not that bad, is it?
We've got NHS. We've got, like, job seekers allowance. Exactly. We've got council tax and council houses and all them things.
Running water, flushing toilet.
Exactly. So it's like, life's not that hard, number one. And number two, I don't like it when everyone's like, oh, this ain't the life I chose, like, it just chose me. And no, it's because you got too much pride to go and get a job. You think you're too good for that job, so you're going to go out and push drugs or whatever. And then you think, like, that you have to do it when you don't have to do it. There's always a way in this country. I don't care what no one says to me.
Flash, make sure that gets edited into this, because that was some serious stuff. Do you second what your brother said?
Yeah, man. I hear
and if there was an MC that you could click your fingers and get rid of today, who would it be?
No one, because if I got a problem with an MC now, I would do that. That's just me being honest, isn't it?
Yeah.
So I don't have that problem with no MC. I hope everyone is successful. I don't wish death or people not doing well. Because that's what girls do, isn't it? Like that's a jealousy. That's some moist thing, but that's not
moist. Is that the word? Yeah.
Yeah,
that's moist.
We're supposed to strengthen the scene, so we need good rappers that are doing well. Like, we need that, otherwise we ain't going to have a scene. If there's like 5 to 10 people that are only doing this, how are we going to get to a big level, to the point where we don't even need labels? Like, it's not going to happen. So.
Well, guys, you guys are killing me. I love it. But I'm going to have to let you get back to your photo shoot with Urban Flash. I'm going to catch you on the other side.
They're looking at me away when really they should be happy. We're trying to get things away so we can make good things happen. And it would make sense if you were proud of become a rapper, because we're stamping authority wherever the map is. And to my face, it's all you're sick, your brother's sick, but in a different circle, you're mouthing on some other shit. Bro, this is my life and I don't do it for the fun of it.
Okay, so welcome back. And how was your photo shoot with Urban Flash?
Yeah, it was cool, man. Like I said before, like, this is the beginning, so we're not tired of this shit yet, and interviews and all of that, so yeah, it's cool.
And then this is like your first interview that you've done together as a duo, so there's so much more of that to come. But I'm gonna ask you not a controversial question, but seeing as you're quite real, when you watch other artists doing videos, is there anything that you see repeatedly happening that you just get sick of seeing from other artists and how they answer questions, or you know what they do in their videos?
The way they carry themselves is like, I don't know, some people might be shy. Like, the camera might come out and you're nervous. And a lot of people, like, more people than you realise in music are shy. But some people, like, they'll be like, you're right. And like, yeah, I'm all right still. And they're like, they don't encourage any conversation. Or they act like they're, like, a robot. or they don't have a family and they don't have a heart and they don't love things, they don't dislike things, they don't hate nothing. It's like no one really don't want to open up. But then how is your audience going to look at that and feel that they know you at all apart from just your music? You know what I mean? It don't make sense.
And could that be because a lot of people get into music not realising that the money doesn't, it takes a bit of a while to come, so you've baited up your face and all the online virals, everybody knows you, you know, you've got a million hits on YouTube, but you still live in your ends. So could that be why people are a bit more...
Must be, because obviously it's not good being a bait face with no money, innit? So that's why you gotta be smart with the music you're making and where it's going and what you're doing with it.
I don't buy music digitally, innit? Like if I really, really like someone and I really support their music, I'll go and buy like a hard copy just for the sake of it. But generally speaking, I don't buy music. Like, I don't buy anyone's music. And I think what's happened, like, this ain't the 90s. Like, if we were signing in the 90s, we'd be rich already, just rich, and then making loads of dough. But it's not that anymore. So the game's changing. And it is, like, there's so many rappers that like, everyone's a rapper. Every day, there's a new rapper, and then you get bombarded with free music anyway. They're like, oh, can you download this? Can you hear this? And people automatically gonna start thinking that it's shit. So it's like it kind of lowers the general quality of music, but it's growth at the end of the day. But I don't.
I would buy music. Like I tried to buy Femme Phil's album.
Shout out to Femme.
I know Femme's gonna think I'm blaming him, but I'm not blaming him. I went Lewisham and Bromley to get his album in it, but obviously it's not there, sold out and that, so whatever, he's doing well that way. But shout out to Femme, I'm gonna get that. I'm gonna get
eyes closed, out now. See, I know my stuff.
See, I would only buy Femme's album because I'm supporting Femme, you get me? But when it's like, I'm gonna be honest with you, when it's people in America and shit, like, I don't really buy their stuff.
Right, so how good of rappers are you? If I give you two words right now, can you? I'm just joking. It's fake. I'm just joking, bitch. That was just jokes. Yeah, that was just jokes. Okay, how can people contact you if they want to get to know you guys? Because I've had such fun today. I'm like family. Yeah. I'm not the new sister. Cool. See what I'm saying? In the legacy? The stalker in the legacy, yeah? Kiss face. So, what's the Twitter, hun?
Young Ads TL. Like, correct spelling. YONUNGADZTL.
Fantastic. And yours is?
Benjamin_AD. And yeah.
Fantastic. And how about this? Mine's Dynamic Stalker. Can you both follow me now? Let's do this. Like on camera. What? No, we don't know what it's going. Live on camera. Come on.
We could do that anyway. Obviously, my phone, it's not connecting to the internet at the moment, is it? But
shit.
Nah, the cat's dead.
Do you know what it is? There is no love out here for a stalker. There's no love out here, but you know what? It was lovely meeting you lot. Group hug. Group hug. I'm out. So, we have to go. Let them get their cab.
A lot of people wanna make choices, but me, dead that. Yeah. I'm a young man now, respect that. I don't wanna talk, you can give me the cash and show young rat where all of the checks at. They wanna get revenge by talking like I'm a dead man, dead that. Trust me, this ain't a game, so you can't revive yourself. When a 4-5 bust and the full clip's done and the dust is set, you can die yourself, this ain't a game. No one in the scene can take my name, they can't spit, I will spit, they're all fake. I'm as real as it gets, I look for inspiration, but I can't find nobody yet. They don't realise young ads and I'm as dope as it gets.
I'm as dope as it gets. If you wanna disagree, we can go for the test. If you really wanna do it, we can go and we can prove it.
Yo,
I'm moving, it's useless, they just ain't gonna match it.
I'm as dope as it gets, yeah. Trying to clock feds on the left. Feed my people, I'm down to battle, guys. Sitting back watching the news on Channel 5. I won't stop writing till I put a white gold chain on the neck of my life.
Breakthrough UK. Who do you know to tell me if you're breakthrough?